Over the last 10 weeks, I have been testing out the top 7 best-selling, most popular orthopedic dog beds on the market in an effort to find the best dog bed for large dogs. In this review, you will learn how well each dog bed performed in our testing for myself and my 2 adult Mastiffs. If you are new here, my name is Stephanie, aka Big Dog Mom, and on this channel, I provide information and resources to help you and your big dog live your best life together. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for stopping back for another video. By definition, an orthopedic dog bed should be made of high-quality supportive or memory foam that conforms to your dog's body, evenly redistributing their weight across the surface, whereby protecting your dog's joints and spine and reducing painful pressure points on their joints and hips. The testing we are about to get into revealed to me that what is meant by orthopedic in the pet bed market is far from uniform. This is no different than a dog food claiming to be all natural or premium, with absolutely no requirement that the food contain any higher quality ingredients or change in the nutritional standards for such labeling. In this comprehensive review, I will be breaking down all 7 of the most popular orthopedic dog beds and sharing how each of them scored in our testing across 10 different metrics important to dog owners. A quick disclaimer before we dive in. While some, but not all, of the beds were sent to me for this testing and review, none of the bed manufacturers have been able to preview my content before it is published on BigDogMom.com and here on YouTube for you. My rankings for all of the dog beds were based on quality and merit, regardless of how they were acquired. Furthermore, I am not being paid by anyone for this review. My objective is to share with you an unbiased, real-world review of some of the most popular dog beds to peel the curtain on the marketing and get to the truth. If you are looking for a little more detail about each of these beds and our testing, be sure to read the comprehensive review on BigDogMom.com. I will include the link to that and all of the beds in our testing in the description box below. For full transparency, some of the links will be affiliate links from which I may earn a small commission if you make a purchase using that link. You will not notice anything different on your end, the same price and product as everyone else sees, but when you use my link, it lets the company know who sent you, and it helps me continue to produce free content here and on my blog. So thank you so much for using my links when you can. I greatly appreciate your support. With that disclaimer out of the way, let me share a little more about how each of the beds was tested and the metrics I used to measure them. Dog beds were selected based on popularity and gross sales on Amazon, reviews within the large dog community, and popularity within the big dog mom audience. With the exception of one, all of the beds selected for this review are marketed as orthopedic and specially marketed for large and giant breed dogs. In order to test the beds fairly, I set up a series of locations around my house. These were all areas where my dogs frequently sleep or lay. Dog beds were placed in the following locations throughout my house: our homeschool room, basement living room, sunroom, living room, main, upstairs landing, and upstairs landing by our laundry room. If you have watched any of the videos on my channel, you have likely come across the boys laying in one or more of these locations. Each dog bed was placed in a given location for 1 week, then rotated to the next location the following week. As the beds were rotated to the next location, the covers were removed, washed, and dried. While this review includes the 7 best-selling dog beds, I only rotated around the 6 beds I had no prior experience with. The Big Barker dog bed, which we will get to in a few minutes, was not included. I wanted to prioritize the new beds with the limited space I have in my house. Every week during the 10-week testing period, I washed each bed's cover to see how well they held up in the laundry. In the final analysis, I used the following 10 metrics to determine which orthopedic dog bed is the best for large dogs. Scores for each metric are based on a 0 to 5 scale, with 5 being the highest. Beds were then ranked based on the individual raw scores. Trust me, these will make sense shortly. As you see these metrics, consider which one of them are most important for you and your dog. You may wish to jot these down or take a screenshot and prioritize your list. Here they are. First, cleanliness. How easy was the dog bed to wash and keep clean? Second, the quality and durability of the cover fabric. One of the most important metrics was the next one, the quality and durability of the foam or cushioning used in the bed. The quality and durability of the zipper. This one may seem strange, but I've purchased products in the past where the zipper was the material that failed, and it was incredibly frustrating. I will put a link to a very humorous blog post below if you want to read more about that epic Big Dog Mom fail. Okay, next was the general appearance and smell with use with 2 big dogs. In other words, how disgusting did the bed get in between washes? Okay, and then was the bed waterproof? How many size or color options does the manufacturer offer? Speaking of the manufacturer, I wanted to consider where the bed is made and if there is a warranty offered. The last two metrics are affordability, which is self-explanatory, and our drool score, or how well my Mastiffs like the bed. Without further ado, let's take each bed one at a time, and then we'll wrap it up in the end with some final thoughts and conclusions you will definitely want to stay for. I am presenting these beds in the order I unboxed them, with no rhyme or reason to the order. First up is the Kirkland Signature 42-inch round pet bed sold at Costco. This is one of the most popular dog beds marketed specifically for large breed dogs. I purchased this bed at my local Costco, so there was no unboxing required. Unique among all of the beds I tested, this one comes with a baffled liner design that keeps the 100% recycled fiber fill in place to provide your dog with maximum loft. It has a very nice upholstery grade home decor fabric cover that is removable and machine washable for easy care. I do really like the gray cream color scheme, which is nice and neutral. The top has a cream plush fabric, as you can see here. This bed is filled with 100% recycled polyester fiber with a woven baffled liner with two chambers for even distribution of fill. Priced at $36.99 at my local Costco, this bed easily fits into the budget of most big dog homes. Additionally, Costco has a very easy returns policy if you aren't satisfied with it for any reason. So what did we think of the Kirkland Signature Round Bed? In terms of cleanliness and ease of cleaning, I gave it a 4. Not the best I've seen, but certainly not the worst. I found the plush top didn't always get entirely clean. The quality of fabric was also okay, but not great, so this too got a score of 4. In terms of foam, again, this bed doesn't have foam. It is stuffed with the recycled polyester fiber, which I didn't love. It was very lumpy for the dogs and did not seem like it would retain its fullness over time. At the end of 10 weeks of testing, the Kirkland Round Dog Bed had an approximate depth of 7 inches of fiber fill at rest. With the weight of one Mastiff, that is over 200 pounds, the fill was compressed to approximately 1 inch to 1.5 inches. For this reason, I am giving this metric a score of 2. The zipper was pretty good, no major flaws. It was a standard zipper, giving it a score of 4 out of 5. In terms of the bed's appearance and smell as my dogs used it, put simply, it was pretty gross, earning a score of 2. The cream plush top was noticeably dirty with dirt, dog hair, and slobber in between each washing of the cover, making it somewhat unsightly. The Kirkland round bed is not waterproof, and there is no option to get a waterproof liner for it, so I gave this metric a 0. Additionally, while I like the look of this model, there are no other size or color options available, so the next metric also scored a 1. The next metric is more about the company. With this one, I had to balance the fact that the bed is made in China, but does have a very good return policy. I felt like a score of 3 made sense here. This bed scored an easy 5 out of 5 for affordability, coming in at the least expensive dog bed in this review. And lastly, drool score. What did my two Mastiffs think of the Kirkland Signature Round Bed from Costco? Put simply, they didn't care for it at all, giving it a score of 2. To summarize, I'm going to share a list of the pros and cons, what we liked and what we didn't like about this bed. First, what we liked. When the bed was clean, the appearance was nice. I do really like the neutral colors, especially the light gray, which matches the color scheme in our home. The cover seemed well made with a pretty thick fabric, and you can't beat the return policy at Costco. But what didn't we like? First, the plush cream top got pretty disgusting when dirty with dog hair and slobber. I generally stay away from things that are plush with my dogs because of the slobber. The size was not near big enough for large and giant breed dogs, in my opinion. Both Junior and Sully struggled to lay on and get comfortable on this bed. Often they would look longingly at it as though they were trying to figure out how to get on it, only to give up and lay next to it. It is not waterproof, which is a huge negative for big dog homes and does not come in any other size or color options. The polyester fill was very lumpy and uncomfortable for the dogs and compressed substantially when they walked or laid on it. It is made in China, which is a huge negative for me, and in the end, Junior and Sully just didn't love laying on it. The use case for this bed is someone with a small to medium-sized clean dog that is not expecting it to last for multiple years. It is an affordable, cheaply made dog bed, easy to replace when it gets too worn out. That said, I do not recommend this bed for large and giant breed dog owners due to the bed's size and fill. Sully and Junior were put off by the lumpy polyester fill under them, the instability and slipping of the bed on the floor, and that they simply did not fit on the bed. Next on the list is the Bedsure XXL Orthopedic Dog Bed. This bed measures 53 inches by 42 inches with a sleeping area of 44.5 by 37.5 inches and features a four-sided bolster design with a high-density egg crate foam for support. It comes with a waterproof inner liner, two-sided zipper, and a non-slip bottom. This bed sells on Amazon for $115.99 with a typical return policy of 30 days. It comes vacuum sealed and compressed in one large box and takes virtually no time to fully inflate and be ready for your dog to lay on. Okay, so how did we score the Bedsure Orthopedic Dog Bed? In terms of ease to clean, I gave this bed a 3. The bolsters are not removable, so you will need to have a fairly large washer and dryer and very little else in the load in order to clean it. Beyond that, I found attempting to bundle and cram the dirty cover into the washer a less than enjoyable experience, one that I almost needed to change clothes after doing. The quality and durability of the cover fabric was just okay. It has a velvety texture, which is nice to the touch, but seemed to attract dog hair and slobber pretty quickly. And while I very much liked the non-slip surface on the bottom, after 10 weeks of washes, there is some deterioration on the underside of the cover, which I would expect to worsen over time. For all of these reasons, I am giving the cover a score of 3. Next is the quality and durability of the foam. The Bedsure Dog Bed uses a CertiPure US certified polyurethane egg crate foam. Unfortunately, I didn't take a measurement of the foam when I unboxed the bed. However, after 10 weeks of testing, it still has a depth of 3 inches at rest. With the weight of one Mastiff, the foam was compressed to approximately 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch. While the manufacturer states that egg crate foam is the optimal therapeutic support for dogs and has the advantage of increased airflow throughout the spaces of the foam, the fact that my dogs were basically laying on the ground makes me question both claims. In the end, I landed on a score of 2 for this metric. The generic zippers seemed perfectly functional and I had no issues giving them a score of 4. In terms of the general appearance and smell with use, unfortunately, I could only award a score of 2 for this metric for the reasons I mentioned just a minute ago. The Bedsure Dog Bed comes with a terrific waterproof liner, which I verified does in fact work, easily warranting a score of 5 out of 5 here. On Amazon, Bedsure has a plethora of size and color options, again, giving them a score of 5 for this metric as well. This is another dog bed that is manufactured in China. However, the return policy is reasonable through Amazon, giving them a score of 3. Priced at $115.99 for the extra extra large size and just over $100 for the extra large, the Bedsure Dog Bed is certainly within the price range for most dog owners, giving it an easy score of 5 out of 5 for affordability. And lastly, what did Junior and Sully think of this dog bed? When given the choice between this bed and a few of the others, both dogs tended to choose the other beds. Perhaps this was due to the compression of the foam not giving them enough relief, I don't know. But because it didn't seem to me that either dog sought this bed out, I am giving them a drool score of 3. So what did we like about the Bedsure Orthopedic Dog Bed? First, I felt like the size and weight of the bed was great. It was easy to move when rotating the beds around the house and easy to maneuver when taking the cover on and off. The XXL size was perfect for giant breed dogs. I love the included waterproof liner and the plethora of size and color options. No matter what your decor is, you should be able to find a color that fits. And lastly, I really liked the non-slip bottom of the cover. This is so handy if your house has a lot of tile and hard surfaces like ours does. My list of cons is a little longer for this bed, unfortunately. First, I didn't love that you can't remove the bolsters from the cover. This made washing the cover very difficult. It was hard to cram the whole thing in the washer and dryer, and also difficult to get fully dry. The velvety fabric looks nice when clean, but with two hairy, slobbery dogs, it went from nice to nasty in about 30 seconds. And I'm sorry, but egg crate foam is thin, and I would definitely not define it as orthopedic. To be fair, the product information does give this bed a max weight of 150 pounds, but even at 150, I have a hard time believing there would be much, if any, support over the long term with egg crate foam. My boys were basically laying on the floor at the 10-week compression test. And lastly, the Bedsure Dog Bed is manufactured in China, which, again, is a con for me. In summary, because the bolsters can't be removed, I found cleaning the Bedsure Orthopedic Dog Bed to be incredibly frustrating at times. You need a very large washer and dryer to shove the cover with the bolsters in. And due to the velvety fabric, if you have a dog that sheds or drools, this is a bed that will need to be washed at a minimum of every week. And at the end of 10 weeks, there is some significant visible deterioration on the underside of the cover, which I would expect to worsen over time. Finally, the egg crate foam was very thin, easily compressed, and ultimately not what I would consider orthopedic, despite the marketing claims. Let's move on to bed number 3, the Mastiffs Orthopedic Dog Bed. I hope I'm saying that name right. According to the company, the Mastiffs Dog Bed is an orthopedic bed with 5 inches of egg crate foam surrounded by a removable, machine washable, 3-layer outer cover, which is 100% waterproof. The cover has a 300 GSM ultra plush top and an anti-scratch non-slip pad to ensure the dog is secure and stable on the bed. The extra large size bed measures 54 inches by 44 inches by 5 inches tall and is lightweight at only 10.7 pounds. It comes packed with the foam individually wrapped, the cover was neatly folded separately inside the box with directions on how to properly care for the bed. Available on Amazon for $79.99 and returnable within 30 days. With those details out of the way, how did the Mastiffs Orthopedic Dog Bed fare in our testing? First, while the cover is super easy to take on and off and is machine washable, the challenge I had with it was getting it dry. As directed, I placed the cover in the dryer on cold for a normal hour-long cycle and would end up having to repeat the cycle 3 to 4 times before the bed was mostly dry. It never actually got completely dry in the dryer, however, so I soon resorted to drying it 3 to 4 times in the dryer, then hanging it over my banister for several hours to completely dry before putting it back on the bed. This process was tedious to say the least, and for that reason, I gave this metric a score of 3. In terms of the quality and durability of the cover, I awarded this bed a 3.5 with deductions due to the significant wear on the underside of the cover during my 10-week inspection, which I would expect to worsen over time. Similar to the Bedsure dog bed, the Mastiffs dog bed also uses an egg crate foam, which they state is 5 inches thick. Unfortunately, I did not measure the foam when I unboxed it, so perhaps it was 5 inches. At the end of 10 weeks of testing, however, the bed had an approximate foam depth of 4 inches at rest. The foam compressed to only 0.5 inch with the weight of 1 Mastiff. This insufficient foam support resulted in a score of 2 out of 5. The quality and durability of the zipper was very good, giving the bed a score of 4. And while the bed looks nice when clean, due to the plush top, it quickly soiled with 2 Mastiffs. This will be another bed that will need to be cleaned every week if you have a dog that sheds or drools. Because of this, I'm giving the Mastiffs a score of 3 here. An easy 5 out of 5 for being waterproof. The nice thing is the Mastiffs cover is waterproof, so there is no need to have a separate waterproof liner over the foam. One thing to note is that I would expect the wear spots I observed under the cover to eventually affect how well the cover protects the foam from wetness. And as is sometimes the case with products sold on Amazon, the size and color availability is a little confusing. Some sizes have several colors and others don't. So for that reason, I gave this bed a score of 3.5. Along the same lines, this is another product that is made in China and sold almost exclusively on Amazon, so the return policy is based on Amazon's terms. The Mastiffs Orthopedic Dog Bed gets a 5 out of 5 for affordability at a price point of only $79.99. And finally, what do Junior and Sully think of this bed? We are giving the Mastiffs Dog Bed a 3 out of 5 for the drool score due to the lack of foam support. That said, the boys liked the overall surface area and seemed genuinely happy to have an alternative to the hard tile floor. Let's quickly run through what we liked and didn't like about the Mastiffs Orthopedic Dog Bed. We all loved the surface size and the weight of this bed. It was just easy to pick up and move and had more than enough space for my Mastiffs to lay entirely on the bed without falling off. I love that the cover has a non-slip bottom and is waterproof, negating the need to buy a separate waterproof liner. And finally, I appreciate that the bed is an affordable option for most dog families. So what didn't we like? First and foremost, the egg crate foam is very thin, easily compressed under the weight of my dogs, and therefore not what I would consider supportive or orthopedic in the sense that it is providing any level of cushioned or therapeutic relief for my dog's arthritis or hips and joint pain. To be fair, the product labeling does state that this bed has a maximum weight of 150 pounds, but I'm not sure the 50 fewer pounds would have made that much difference difference in this case. The plush cover was very hard to keep clean and would become very dirty very quickly, making this a bed that truly needed to be washed every single week in our home. And when washed, the Mahique cover was nearly impossible to get dry, which was an ongoing source of frustration throughout the 10 weeks of testing. And lastly, the Mahique is manufactured in China. Let me give you a few final thoughts about the Mahique orthopedic dog bed before we move on. With one of the thinnest foams in the testing group, the Mahique bed was more like a pad than a dog bed for my Mastiffs. We liked how easy this bed was to take the cover on and off and move, but the compromise was in the overall quality of the bed. I do not agree with the claim that this bed is an orthopedic bed. Once again, there does not seem to be any regulation on the use of that term. When Junior and Sully step on or lay on this bed, they are basically on the floor with little to no support for their bones and joints. All of that said, I would recommend the Mahique dog bed if you have a small to medium-sized dog that doesn't shed or drool. Moving on to our fourth dog bed, a crib or toddler mattress. Yes, you heard me right. I wanted to include a crib mattress in this review because I know many, many big dog owners who use these for their dogs. The argument is that the foam support is just as good as a premium dog bed, but at a quarter of the price. I wanted to test this out, so here we are. Keep in mind, there are many other crib and toddler mattress options that you can buy. I ordered one off Amazon for $53.99, and that is what I'm using for this review. While I have no doubt that there are higher quality crib mattresses on the market, I think you will find my review of this one more than fair and consistent no matter which one you buy. The product labeling of the crib mattress I got states that it is made with premium foam to provide optimal support and stability with an advanced high weight distribution six-sided one-piece design, combining the benefits of alpaca and long staple cotton for a delicate, soft, refreshing, and breathable feel. It fits any standard full-size crib and toddler bed and claims to be moisture absorbent, breathable, odorless, and noise-free. The size of the bed is 52 inches by 27.6 inches by 5 inches tall, and it weighs 8 pounds. It is manufactured in China and comes with a 7-year limited warranty according to the product listing. So how did the crib mattress fare as a dog bed for two Mastiffs? I am going to go through this one relatively quickly. In terms of cleanliness, I gave the crib mattress a 1. There is no way to clean it. If you decide to get one of these for your dog, I highly recommend buying a sheet or liner for it that you can take on and off while keeping the mattress clean. The fabric on the bed is very soft and seemed of very good quality. For a baby, it would have been fabulous. For big dogs, not so much, giving it a score of 3.5. The foam on the bed was very firm and seemed well capable of supporting a Mastiff. At the end of the 10 weeks of testing, the crib mattress had an approximate depth of 4 to 4.5 inches of foam at rest. With the weight of one Mastiff, the foam was compressed to approximately 2 inches. This was significantly better than many of the other beds in this review. For that reason, I gave the quality and durability of the foam a score of 4 out of 5. Since the crib mattress doesn't have a removable cover, it doesn't have a zipper. For this reason, the score for the crib mattress is being taken from a total of 45 points instead of 50. So how did we like the general appearance and smell of the crib mattress? In the 10 weeks of testing, I would say just so-so. I knew from the beginning this bed was going to get destroyed with my dirty dogs, but in the end, I was pleasantly surprised by how well it held up and how decent it looked. I made the decision to lay the bed with the same side up throughout the testing to get a true sense of how gross it could get, but again, it didn't look that bad. Over time, I have no doubt this bed will get unsightly and smelly, so for that reason, I gave this metric a score of 3. The bed is not waterproof, so that scored a 0. In fact, the product instructions that came with it say, do not get the product wet with water or other liquids. Yikes. While there are a plethora of color options for crib mattresses, there is only one size that is standard. So for that reason, I gave it a score of 3.5. This particular mattress was made in China with a typical Amazon return policy. The company states they have a 7-year limited warranty, but my guess is that would not be applicable if you are using it for a dog bed. Hence the score of 3 out of 5 here. Another easy 5 out of 5 for affordability at the price point of under $60. I felt conflicted on the drool score. This was a bed that the boys treated like the Kirkland signature round bed. They looked at it like they couldn't figure out what to do with it. It would slip and slide on the ground under them and was so narrow, neither dog could get comfortable on it. For this reason, the boys' drool score for the crib mattress is a 3 out of 5. It supported them when they were on it, but it was simply not big enough for them. Let's quickly cover a few pros and cons before I give you my final thoughts and recommendations on the crib mattress as a bed for large dogs. The two things we really liked about this bed was the firm and supportive foam and the affordability. However, a crib mattress is not big enough for large and giant breed dogs. It's simply too narrow for dogs with long legs. Because there is no removable cover, there is no way to clean it, and it's not waterproof. Two huge problems if you are using a crib mattress as your dog's bed. Lastly, yet another bed made in China. With that, here are a few final thoughts before we move on. The biggest issue with using a baby mattress for two giant breed dogs is the width of the bed. It's simply too narrow, and my dogs were constantly falling off of it. So this mattress didn't work for us at all. I do, however, think it could work for some dog families with a few modifications. Some large breed dogs may fit on this bed. I'm thinking a smaller Labrador, a Pointer, or even a Siberian Husky. However, I would highly recommend purchasing a waterproof liner and additional cover sheets that you can take on and off to keep the bed clean and smelling nice. I would not expect the foam to last more than a year, but at this price, most dog owners will likely be fine with the trade-off. I will include links below to some options for liners and covers if you decide to go in this direction for your dog. Moving on. If you are getting value from this video, would you hit that like button and let me know? Have you used any of the beds we just reviewed? I would love to hear what your experience was with them. Let me know in the comments below. The final three dog beds are coming up. First up is the Bully Bed Orthopedic Bed for Big Dogs. That is a mouthful. I'm just going to call this Bully Bed for short in this review. I got the size XXL, which measures a whopping 60 inches by 48 inches by 7 inches tall and is 34 pounds. A few stats from the company about the Bully Bed. Backed by an industry-leading 20-year no-flat warranty, the Bully Bed uses CertiPure US Certified Safe Memory Foam for maximum support. It comes with a removable, washable microfiber cover with a non-slip base and a waterproof liner that is included with your purchase. It has heavy-duty, chew-resistant zippers and an ultra-supportive headrest for optimal comfort. While manufactured in China, Bully Bed is a family-owned small business based in Florida. The price of the XXL size is $359.99. However, the extra-large size may work well for most giant breed dogs. The dimensions of the XL size are 52 inches by 34 inches by 7 inches tall, and the cost of that one is $249.99. The Bully Bed is shipped in one enormous, very heavy box, with the bed shrink-wrapped in one bag. As soon as the seal on the outer plastic was broken, the bed began to inflate. My initial reaction was very positive, but also a little taken aback by the sheer size of this bed. Here is how we rated the Bully Bed after 10 weeks of testing. In terms of cleanliness and ease of cleaning, the Bully Bed could not have been easier. The cover was easy to take on and off, with the only difficulty being the sheer size and weight of the bed. Other than that, the Bully Bed was easy to clean, a clear 5 out of 5. The cover fabric is thin, but the microfiber top and non-slip bottom are a terrific, very dog-friendly combination. My only gripe with the cover was first how thin it is. I worry about degradation over time or even accidental punctures. In my 10 weeks of testing, however, I didn't observe any issues with the integrity of the cover on the top or bottom. That said, when you flip the cover inside out, I was quite disappointed in the workmanship of the seams. There is so much fraying of the unfinished stitching on the underside that the zipper often gets caught in it. I am not a seamstress by any means, but I do have a serger machine. It's an extra step, but one that would really help the mess that is the underside of the Bully Bed cover. It would make it look much more premium and finished, especially considering the price they are asking for it. So in the end, I landed on a score of 4 for the cover. It is very nice, but not perfect. The foam is heavenly, straight up. I have always loved a very firm memory foam. We had a Tempur-Pedic bed for nearly 15 years, and on cold days, it was amazing. It would be firm, but ultra supportive. At the end of 10 weeks of testing, the Bully Bed had an approximate depth of 7 inches of memory foam at rest. With the weight of one Mastiff, that's over 200 pounds, the foam was compressed to approximately 3.5 inches. With the caveat that the foam is made in China, and I did observe some splitting at my 10-week inspection, overall I gave the foam a score of 4.5 out of 5. The zipper was, like many of the other beds, nice but not outstanding. Part of my issue with the Bully Bed was the bits of thread constantly in the way of the zipper, for which I deducted a point for. The Bully Bed is a beautiful, very clean looking bed, even when it's not. The microfiber cloth is so easy to brush off, and the gray color seemed to hide most of the dirt, dog hair, and slobber. I didn't notice any smell as I washed the cover weekly, and it pretty much stayed clean even in between washes. This is an easy 5 out of 5 for me. This bed comes with a waterproof liner already on the bed and included with your purchase, which is another 5 out of 5. In terms of size and color options, Bully Bed offers quite a few options on their website. They have this one, the original Bully Bed, a three-sided bolster bed, a chew-resistant bed, an infrared dog bed, which I am interested in learning more about, and a few others. All in sizes medium, large, extra large, and XXL. Tan, chocolate, and gray are the only colors offered at this time from what I can see on their website. All three of the colors are a pretty dark shade, and with the exception of the gray, I wasn't a huge fan of them. For this reason, I deducted a point for a score of 4 out of 5 for this category. While the Bully Bed is fully manufactured and assembled in China, it does come with an outstanding 20-year warranty, and the family-owned company is based here in the United States. I felt like a score of 4 out of 5 was fair for this metric. I would consider the Bully Bed an investment rather than the standard purchase of a disposable dog bed. The price for the large is in excess of $200, and the XXL size that I have was nearly $360. With the 20-year warranty, this is a bed that you only buy once, for sure. For this reason, I'm giving the Bully Bed a score of 4 out of 5 for affordability. And finally, what did Junior and Sully think of the Bully Bed? Put simply, they loved it. When the Bully was positioned by the back door in our sunroom, the boys would crowd the door to come in and seem to race to see who could get on the bed first. Both dogs fell into very hard sleeps on this bed with very loud snoring, the telltale sign that they have hit maximum comfort. Let's go over what we liked and didn't like about the Bully Bed super quickly. The foam on the Bully Bed is incredibly thick and supportive and showed minimal compression at the end of 10 weeks of testing. I loved that the waterproof cover is included with your purchase. They offer a 20-year no-flat guarantee, which states that if it flattens by more than 2.5 inches anytime within those 20 years, they will replace it one time at no charge for you. That is amazing. I also really loved the microfiber top and non-slip bottom of the cover. While very thin, it was easy to get and keep clean. Bully Bed is a family-owned small business based here in the United States. I reached out to them several times over the last few weeks with questions, and I was happy with the customer service I received. And last but not least, both of my Mastiffs loved the Bully Bed. With all of those positives, unfortunately, no bed is perfect. So what didn't we like about the Bully Bed? First, the XXL size dog bed is incredibly heavy, weighing in at 34 pounds. That doesn't sound like a lot, but when you are trudging up a full flight of stairs with a giant bed of memory foam, it's not easy. I found out quickly after unboxing this bed that I need to go back to CrossFit. I've gotten pretty weak. There were several things I didn't love about the cover as well. It was very thin, as was the zipper, and you can see during my 10-week inspection, the workmanship on the underside was not good. I am not sure why they left all of the cut fabric unfinished, but it was both unsightly and frustrating at times with a mess of threads everywhere. I am also not in love with the colors they offer, the tan and gray being the best of the three options. I would love to see more neutral shades that would go with most home decor in the future. One other comment about the foam, and we found this with our Tempur-Pedic bed, is that memory foam can sleep more warm than other types of foam. You know your dog and his or her preferences, and this may depend on where you live. In Arizona, Junior and Sully may have opted for the cold tile floor versus the Bully Bed. Here in Michigan, they love it. That is just something to keep in mind. And lastly, as I said earlier, the Bully Bed is unfortunately made in China. Let me wrap this up by saying I did not anticipate liking the Bully Bed as much as I did. The foam was supremely comfortable for the dogs and seemed to hug their bodies in a very supportive way. I was a little concerned during my 10-week inspection to see the foam splitting and bits of it coming off, but hopefully that won't continue. Unfortunately, I didn't pay close enough attention when I unboxed the bed to see if those rips were there from the beginning or if those occurred in use over the 10 weeks. The only major downfall I found with the Bully Bed was with the cover, which wasn't very thick. I am used to the very thick micro suede cover of the Big Barker, so compared to that, the Bully Bed cover doesn't seem like it will hold up as well over time. You can purchase new covers for $80 or a heavy-duty cover for $135 for the XXL size bed. I'm very interested in trying the heavy-duty cover at some point since the cover was the biggest negative of this bed for large dogs. In the end, I would definitely recommend the Bully Bed for large and giant breed dog homes. Now, is it the best dog bed on the market? Let's review the last two beds and we will see. The next dog bed I reviewed is incredibly popular. It is the Fur Haven Quilted Sofa Dog Bed. The Fur Haven company offers four USA-made foam options, of which the full support solid orthopedic foam version is the one included in this review. The quilted sofa dog bed comes with a quilted polyester zippered removable machine washable cover that has a two zipper design that allows access to the foam base and bolsters. This bed is not waterproof, but you can buy a water resistant liner separately. The jumbo plus size you see me unboxing here is 53 inches by 40 inches by 5 inches tall in size with a sleep surface of 41 inches by 34 inches. The website clearly states this bed is for breeds up to 125 pounds. My boys are just a wee bit over that. The Fur Haven sofa bed is priced at $129.99, both on furhaven.com and on Amazon. In terms of manufacturing, the foam is made in the USA. However, the cover is made in China. The label on the bed states that it is assembled in the US with US and imported materials. Fur Haven offers free returns within 30 days, or if you register your bed within 14 days of purchase, you can sign up for their 60-day worry-free program, which they say covers accidental damage for 60 days and manufacturer defects for 90 days. So what did we think of the Fur Haven quilted sofa dog bed? First, I found this bed very easy to clean, giving it an easy 5 out of 5 for cleanliness. The bolsters are removable and very easy to take in and out when the cover needed washing. That said, the cover fabric was just okay. While the bed looks nice at first glance, over time, more and more dog hair became embedded and difficult to get off even with washing. Additionally, at my 10-week inspection, I noticed significant ripping of the batting on the underside of the quilt. Because that batting is what is helping provide structure and integrity to the cover, the fact that in only 10 weeks it's ripping is a huge negative. For this reason, I gave the cover a score of 3.5 out of 5. The foam used in this bed is their full support, solid, orthopedic, CertiPure US certified foam, which is high quality, but not what I would consider premium. During my 10-week inspection, the Fur Haven quilted sofa dog bed had an approximate depth of 5 inches of solid orthopedic foam at rest, but compressed to approximately 1 inch under the weight of one Mastiff. For this reason, I gave the Fur Haven foam a score of 4 out of 5. The zipper was of good quality, nothing outstanding or spectacular, giving it a score of 4 out of 5. In terms of the general appearance of the bed, as my dogs were using it, the quilted cover showed some of the dirt, hair, and slobber, but I found it mostly tolerable overall, giving it a score of 4. The quilted cover easily absorbed the drool and slobber, which for a non-waterproof bed is a bit of a concern. I wonder how much damage my dogs were doing to the foam with just slobber and wet paws. Fur Haven does offer quite a few size and color options for this bed, resulting in a score of 4 out of 5. With sizes from medium to jumbo plus and 6 color choices, I think most dog owners can find what they are looking for. I was not wowed by any of the colors except the silver gray, which I really liked. Fur Haven is based in Bellingham, Washington, and specializes in pet beds for dogs and cats. While the foam on the beds is made in the USA, the covers are not. The warranty for the beds is reasonable for the cost of the bed, giving it a score of 4 out of 5. This is an inexpensive bed, so an easy 4.5 out of 5 for affordability. So how did Junior and Sully like the Fur Haven quilted sofa bed? They liked this bed very much. While it didn't seem to be their favorite, they were able to fit on it and sleep comfortably, giving this bed a 4 out of 5 for a drool score. With that said, let's quickly go through what we liked and what we didn't like about the Fur Haven dog bed. I loved the size of the Jumbo Plus bed for large and giant breed dogs. I am not sure I would recommend going down a size, even for a breed as small as a Labrador or German Shepherd. The Jumbo Plus was perfect. I also loved that the bolsters were removable when washing the cover. The Bedsure bolsters drove me crazy, so the Fur Haven was a welcome change each week when I washed the covers. I found the quilted cover easy to clean and loved that the foam was made in the USA. And finally, I appreciate the option to increase the warranty to 60 days to guard against accidental damage. But what didn't we like about this bed? First, the quilted cover seemed to attract dog hair and became increasingly difficult to get the dog hair off over our 10-week testing period. This bed is not waterproof, which is a huge negative for big dog homes. The cover is made in China, and after 10 weeks of testing, I am seeing significant deterioration of the batting on the underside of the cover, which is not good. And lastly, this bed is not recommended for dogs over 125 pounds, which basically rules out many large breed and almost all giant breed dogs. In conclusion, the Fur Haven Quilted Sofa Dog Bed is a nice orthopedic dog bed that my Mastiffs truly enjoyed laying on. While the foam is not the best we have used, it is not the worst either. There was adequate support for a Mastiff-sized dog over the 10-week testing period. However, I would not expect this foam to sustain its integrity and support over even 1 year of daily use. This bed is not waterproof, but you can buy a water-resistant liner separately. This is a huge negative for most dog families, in my opinion. Not only are dogs prone to coming in wet from outdoors, over a dog's lifetime, accidents are bound to happen. I would love to see the company offer a waterproof cover as an optional add-on in the future. The quilted cover looked nice when clean, but it seemed to attract and embed dog hair in it. That said, the cover was very easy to clean and dried quickly through one cold temperature cycle in the dryer. In 10 washes, I have only noticed a little wear around the zipper and seams on the outside. However, the white batting on the underside is breaking down pretty substantially for a less than 3-month-old bed. And lastly, while I like the idea of the 60-day worry-free program, you have to register your bed within 14 days in order to take advantage of that. Otherwise, you have 30 days to return it if you or your dog don't like it. This program is nice, but comes in a distant third compared to the policies of the top two orthopedic dog beds on the market, Big Barker and Bully Beds. That brings us to the last dog bed in this review, the Big Barker Premium Dog Bed. As I stated at the beginning of this review, I have over 9 years of experience with Big Barker dog beds. For that reason, I left my Big Barker bed that is nearly a year old now out of the rotation with the other beds. But in terms of wear and tear, if any bed was going to show compression and deterioration, it would be the Big Barker, given its age and daily use by my two Mastiffs. Let's go over some of the features of the Big Barker in case you are unfamiliar with them. First, Big Barker beds are handcrafted in Pennsylvania using a proprietary blend of American-made foam. A Big Barker dog bed uses a combination of foams in each bed, the 2-inch bottom base layer, the 3-inch support layer in the middle that can handle 180 pounds per square inch, and the 2-inch comfort layer at the top. Big Barker's proprietary foam is what is called open cell, which allows air to move freely through the bed. Other forms, such as memory foam, are closed cell, which can trap hot air between your dog and the bed. This is something I mentioned earlier with the Bully Bed's memory foam. Additionally, they have up to 150 inches of zipper surrounding 75% of each bed, making it easy for you to remove Big Barker's non-shrink covers and throw them in the washing machine. The covers are made with micro suede fabric, which holds up against digging and scores 100,000 or higher on the Weisenbeek abrasion test, the standard for measuring a fabric's ability to withstand surface wear from rubbing. And what is most unique about Big Barker beds is that they have actually been clinically proven to improve quality of life, joint function, and mobility, as shown in a research study that was done at the University of Pennsylvania, which I will link below in the description. The bed you see me unboxing here is the extra large sofa version in the color khaki. It measures 52 inches by 36 inches by 7 inches tall and is priced at $329.95 on the Big Barker website. Big Barkers are 100% made and assembled in the United States and come with a 10-year can't flatten, won't flatten guarantee, as well as a 365-day trial where you can return your bed at any time in the first year if you are not completely satisfied with it. No questions asked. They even pay for the shipping. Okay, with all of those details out of the way, let's dive into the testing. Every one of my Big Barkers have been incredibly easy to clean, and it is one of the features I love best about these beds. Mastiffs, as much as I absolutely adore them, are very messy dogs. And for me, the last thing I want is to have to spend a bunch of time cleaning dog beds just to keep the mess from taking over my home. Big Barker covers are super easy to zip on and off and wash up absolutely beautifully every time. Additionally, even in 9 years of washing these covers, not a single one has failed or shrunk in all of that time. This is an easy 5 out of 5 for us. The only thing I would add about the cover is the beautiful workmanship that you can see went into sewing it all together. The cut fabric is finished nicely using a serger, and rarely are there little strings or pieces of fabric getting in the way of the zipper. Again, another 5 out of 5 for the cover. The USA-made foam on every big barker I have has held up perfectly over many years of daily use. I measured this one-year-old bed along with the others in my testing and found that the bed at rest still has a thickness of approximately 7 inches, and that compresses to about 3.5 inches with the weight of one 200-plus-pound Mastiff. Very impressive and indeed worthy of another perfect score. Big Barker uses only American-made zippers, and they put them around 75% of the bed, making it super easy to take the cover on and off. For this reason, I gave the zipper a score of 5 out of 5. While the Big Barker is not waterproof, you can buy a beautiful waterproof cover separately. I highly recommend getting one of these or buying your bed when they offer one free with the purchase of the bed. That sale is going on right now, so I encourage you to check it out. I will include a link to the waterproof liner below. Because the liner is not normally included with the bed purchase, I deducted 1 point. Big Barker dog beds come in many different sizes and color options, justifying an easy 5 out of 5 again. The bed you see here is the sofa version, but in my previous videos, you've seen the sleek bed, the headrest version, and the car travel bed. Sizes range from large to giant. Interestingly, Big Barker now offers the Barker Jr. and a 4-inch orthopedic sofa bed for small and medium-sized dogs. So they have a little something for everyone now. Since I have already spent time discussing the Big Barker, the company, and their warranty on these dog beds, you won't be surprised that for this, they get another 5 out of 5. Like I mentioned with the Bully bed, the Big Barker dog beds are an investment. Big Barker beds are completely made in America with the highest quality materials, so that unfortunately comes with a cost. I have many videos on Big Barker dog beds on this channel where I go into more detail on this topic, so I will link those below if you'd like to check them out. For now, I will just say that I believe, as a longtime customer of Big Barker, I believe these beds are worth every cent. Big Barker does offer payment plans using Affirm, but I don't recommend going into debt for anything. Save up instead and pay with cash. So for all of these reasons, I'm giving them a score of 3.5 out of 5 for affordability. And lastly, Junior and Sully have always loved their Big Barker beds, so another easy 5 out of 5 for the drool score. Now for the pros and cons. I love that Big Barker is committed to keeping their product made in the USA with USA-based materials. It truly makes them a standout among all other dog bed companies. The durability of the foam is outstanding, and the beds are made for dogs of all sizes. No discrimination for the plus size here. The micro suede covers are thick and incredibly durable over many years of daily use, and a huge plus, they look clean even when they aren't. These covers are beautifully sewn and finished inside and out, making the functionality of the cover and the zipper seamless together. And last, and most importantly, my Mastiffs love their Big Barker beds. On the other hand, here are a few things I don't love about Big Barker. First, unfortunately, the price of these beds is above many families' budgets, as I spoke about a minute ago. The colors they offer are nice, but I would love to see a light gray color option to more closely match my home decor. And lastly, I wish the waterproof cover was included. I love that they often do sales offering the liner free, but if you don't catch that sale, you are looking at another $80 to $100 to add it on. Let me just tell you, testing the 7 most popular best-selling orthopedic dog beds for 10 weeks has been a unique and incredibly rewarding experience. When I purchased my first Big Barker dog bed back in 2015, I was not aware of other orthopedic dog beds. My boss at the time was friends with the founder of Big Barker, and he recommended I try one of the beds for my Mastiffs. As they say, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I've stayed with Big Barker beds for over 9 years now and have never been disappointed. That said, you can't make the claim best dog bed for large dogs if you haven't used other dog beds. This test was that opportunity for me. Each one of the dog beds we tested has its own merit, and depending on the specific needs of your dog and what you are looking for, my choice for the best orthopedic dog bed for large dogs may not be the same as yours. Here is the final ranking for the best dog bed for large dogs, as determined by me and my two Mastiffs. I am including the raw score as well, so you can see numerically how they compare based on my ranking scores we just went through. According to Junior and Sully, they had Big Barker and Bully Bed tied for first, followed by Fur Haven and Bedsure tied for second. The Mahique Dog Bed, Crib Mattress, and Kirkland Signature Round Bed round out the list in 5th, 6th, and 7th place, respectively. For Big Dog Mom, my clear and unequivocal winner for the best dog bed was Big Barker Dog Beds, with Bully Bed coming in second and Furhaven a distant third. Bedsure and Mahique are tied for fourth place, and the Crib Mattress and Kirkland Round Dog Bed came in sixth and seventh, respectively. Have you used any of the dog beds included in this testing? How did our experience compare with yours? Have you tried any other dog beds that are not included in this review? I would love to hear more about your experience with these or any other dog beds in the comments below. And before you go, if you got value from this video, please hit that like button and let me know. And if you haven't done so already, I would love to have you back as a subscriber using the intuitive buttons below. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end of this video, and we will see you in our next one. Bye for now. You don't like say what? Was it cringy?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Fine, I won't say it. I thought it was cute.
You gotta get that piece of the ruler.
June, that's not.
Stop. Don't eat the ruler.
Stop eating the ruler.
Alright, ready?
We're stuck. All the way down to the homeschool home.